Hello, friends. We all understand that a crazy Belarusian dictator hijacked a passenger plane in order to arrest an opposition journalist. But to understand is one thing, to know for sure is quite another. Lukashenko stubbornly pushed the version of a bomb threat on board the plane.
Особо отмечу, сигнал о минировании самолета был получен тоже из-за рубежа.
But in only 3 minutes, I will prove to you now that the dictator is lying. Let's review the chronology. May 23rd, 12:30 p.m., local Minsk time. The Ryanair plane, flight number 4978, traveling from Athens to Vilnius, enters Belarusian airspace. 12:30 p.m. A dispatcher at the Minsk Flight Control Center informs the pilots that a bomb is allegedly planted on board the plane and would be detonated over Vilnius. 12:31 p.m., the controller recommends that the pilots land in Minsk. 12:33 p.m., when the pilots ask where the information came from, the Minsk dispatcher replies that Airport Security Service received an email. He adds that this email was sent to several airports. 12:47 p.m. After numerous suggestions by the Minsk dispatcher, the Ryanair plane activates its distress signal and turns towards Minsk airport. A few minutes later, the plane descends and lands in Minsk. The Belarusian KGB arrests former editor-in-chief of the channel Nexta, Roman Protasevich, and his girlfriend and Russian citizen Sofia Sapega, who were both on board the flight. One day later, a video of Protasevich, with visible evidence of being presumably tortured, was published by the pro-government Telegram channel. A similar video with Sofia Sapega would be published shortly thereafter. Protasevich and Sapega were then placed in a pre-trial detention center in Minsk. Now let's go back in time. May 23rd, 12:30 p.m. The Minsk dispatcher announces that a bomb is on board the Ryanair plane. Then, at 12:33, he clarifies that security services received the information by email. We managed to obtain that email. It actually existed. Here it is. Try not to laugh at the content, just pay attention to the timestamp. 12:57 p.m. 10 minutes have passed since the airplane sent a distress signal and turned towards Minsk. 24 minutes have passed since the dispatcher announced the receipt of this email. 27 minutes have passed since the dispatcher knew about the presence of the supposed bomb on board the plane. Of course, we can assume that psychics work at Minsk Flight Control, or time travelers. However, it looks more like a clumsy cover-up operation. One big fake. It was designed so a dictator, who is out of his mind, could detain an opposition journalist, all while carrying out an act of air piracy and endangering hundreds of people. Separately, I would like to note that as of 12:33 p.m., the Minsk dispatcher mentions the email being sent to several airports. This stands in stark contrast with the fact that the email, as we see, has not yet arrived at Minsk airport, and that according to our information, Vilnius and Athens did not send any alerts to Minsk. So they managed to draw up a plan for the dispatcher of the special services, but did not back it up with appropriately timed supporting emails. What else can we learn from this email? That the Belarusian dictator and his special services do not know how to use technology. Lukashenko said that the email from the Hamas soldiers came from Switzerland.
Сигнал о минировании самолета был получен тоже из-за рубежа, из Швейцарии.
The email, as you can see, was sent from Proton Mail. The Proton Mail server is located in Switzerland. All Proton emails will have the sender's Swiss IP. You can try it yourself. The entire story and the cover-up operation to capture an opposition journalist was made so clumsily that it would be funny if it did not have such sad consequences. As you just saw, the hijacking of the Ryanair plane was not triggered by a terrorist bomb threat. The threat was invented by Lukashenko and his special services. They came up with it on the go, yet didn't manage to refine it properly. Their mistakes were exposed in no time. Nonetheless, Roman Protasevich and Sofia Sapega are under arrest in Minsk and are possibly being tortured. We must make every effort to get these people out. Crazy dictators have no place in Europe in the 21st century. It is far too dangerous for everyone. And I'm not only talking about Lukashenko. Thank you for watching this video. Like it, subscribe to the channel, and get notifications when my new videos are released. See you later!